And we're good to go. Good morning. Sorry about that. Where's my clock? 5 minutes. Sorry about that. A few technical problems. It seems to be the name of the game with Zoom sometimes. So lovely to be back. Morning yoga. It's just like the best time to do yoga. So a lovely class plan this morning. We're going to flow and we're going to do quite a twisting practice. Always great for digestion, for circulation, removing any kind of stagnation, just for energizing in the body. We'd start with ego eradicator, a bit of breath of fire. And then we have a beautiful meditation at the end. And really lovely meditation for bringing us internal. And so let's start. So we'll just start seated, okay? So come into any comfortable seated position for you. So I like to use a cushion. You might use a cushion or a pillow and close your eyes. A couple of deep breaths here, dropping in. There, before I went away, I was saying that my teacher shared the word intimacy as into me I see. And so let this be a practice this morning where your gaze is internal and it's a gaze of a witness observing mind. So really cultivating our relationship with our inner selves. And it's so important that that inner gaze is always kind. So it makes that journey inside a lot safer. It doesn't matter what muck we have inside. It's our directionality, so we're going from darkness to light. Noticing your breath. And it's that familiar feeling of connecting with your inner self. You inside of you. And really try to catch yourself if during the class, if when during the class your mind wanders, thinking about things, and come back again to this. So let's do a little bit of ego eradicator. Ego eradicator, breath of fire. So exhaling through your nose. As you exhale, you draw the navel in. You go at a pace that suits you. If you're in the first few days of your menstrual cycle, then a long, deep breath. So the arms are up, and then draw the fingers in. Thumbs are pointing towards each other. You can see it there in the light. Arms are about 60 degrees. Eyes are closed. And breath of fire. We're going to go for 3 minutes. Eyes drawn to the center of the forehead. And the breath of fire, the power of the breath is in that forceful exhale. The navel draws in and the breath is expelled through the nose. And then the inhale is the same length. And the belly goes in and out like a pendulum. It's not a very forceful breath. It's that the power of the exhale is strong. It's like a pulsing breath and have it steady, consistent. Have that feeling like you could just be doing it the rest of the morning. Find a place that suits you. Stay with it. Be present. Eye gaze to the center of the forehead. Be with what you're doing. Deep in here. And then bring the thumbs to touch overhead. Reach the fingers. Hold the breath. Squeeze up to the pelvic floor. Reach in your arms. Hold. Squeeze. And then slowly exhale. Make a big arc. Circle with your arms. Clearing your energy. Hands to the floor. And then rest your hand on your thighs, on your legs, and just take a moment. Your relationship with yourself is unique to you. Let's do some movement. Let's come to the back. Lying on your back, hands out to the sides, and then bring your knees up on the tabletop. Sink the abs, draw the ribs in, take an inhale. And as you exhale, let your knees fall over towards the left. And keep your right shoulder on the floor. Your navel turns towards the left. Slowly inhale back to center. And then exhale to the right. And the navel draws towards the left. So we'll do a few more of these, just waking up the core and introducing a few twists. So exhaling to bring the knees over to the side. Keep that opposite shoulder on the floor and really conscious of the navel is twisting in the opposite direction to the knees. So this strong activation of your obliques working. Inhale, center. Exhale. Inhale, center. And exhale. Really nice coming to center. Interlace the hands behind you. Head, inhale, extend one leg, and exhale the other. And now if you have any sensitivity, you can pop your hands underneath your lower hips, your lower back. Inhale, and exhale. And sides of the waist go down. Navel towards the spine. Don't let the lower back arch. Lovely massaging action for the lower collar. And stay present. That's it. Nearly there.
Inhale, extend your legs long. Hold, pause, squeeze, pelvic floor, hold. Exhale, release the legs down. Palms facing up and just rest for a moment. Let's go straight in. So we're going to do double leg lifts. So as always, single or double, bent knees or legs straight. You find what works for you. So absolutely great to put your hands over your hips, one leg at a time. Inhale up, exhale down. Or both legs, inhale up, exhale down. If you don't need your hands under your hips, then hands behind your head. So find the version that works for you. Inhaling up, exhaling down. Sides of the waist go down, and really draw the navel to the spine to bring your leg down. So really not letting the lower back arch. We're going for 2 minutes here. I'll tell you when we're 1 minute in. It's a great time to take a little rest and then come back in. Especially if you took a break over 2 weeks, you're going to feel these very quickly. But the body is amazing, right? And so, very quickly, we remember the body builds the strength again. So there we are, 1 minute in. It could be a good time to take a little rest and then come back in. Remember, knees can bent. If this feels off too much, pistoning the legs like we were doing initially, that's also another great option. So always working with your body, right? Adjusting, listening, knowing your edge. Last 20 seconds. Nearly there. Lovely, let's inhale, legs up. Pause, hold, squeeze down the floor. Shaking it really long. Yeah, that's it. And then slowly exhale, release the legs down. Palms facing up. So great, the life fire in the core, navel center. Activate the energy there. And let's just lift up into a bridge. Let's move the energy up towards the heart center. So press your 10 toes into the floor and lifting up. Draw your arms in underneath. Interlace your fingers, so knuckles reaching towards your heels. And now think of not the chin to the chest, but the chest moving to the chin. And now push into the big toe mat and feel the outer hips lifting. Knees extending, lengthening away from the hips. Really nice. And now slowly come over. Bring that, nice. Let's tuck the knees in, roll it up, and let's come all the way around to down dog. Here, first stand up, it might be helpful to bend the knees a little bit, and then straighten. Bend one knee, and then bend the other. And then carefully walk your feet all the way to your hands on top of the mat. Hands to your shins or the floor. Inhale, lift your heart. Exhale, fold in. And then press into your feet. Inhale, come all the way up, reach up. Exhale, hands to heart. And let's flow to some sun salutations. Inhale, reach up.
Exhale, fold forwards. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, step back to plank. Let's take an extra breath here. A deep inhale. And then exhale, elbows in. Knees down, my knees lifted. And reach it all the way to the floor. Flatten your feet, elbows in. Inhale, cobra. And then tuck your toes. Exhale back into down dog. Deep inhale and long exhale. Deep inhale and long exhale. Bend your knees, look through your hands, and walk step or hop to the top of your mat. Inhale, come all the way up. Exhale, hands out. Do two more just like that. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, forward. Inhale, lift your heart. Exhale, step back to plank and lower straight away. So halfway or all the way, knees down on no knees. And then inhale into up dog or cobra. And exhale back into down dog. Take a deep inhale. And a long exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Bend your knees, look through your hands. Walk step up. Top of your mat. Inhale, all the way up, reach up. Exhale, hands to heart. Let's do one more, inhale, reach up. Exhale, fold forwards. Inhale, halfway. No rush. Exhale, step back and lower. So remember, knees can be down, elbows in. Inhale, cobra or up dog. And then exhale back into down dog. Take a deep inhale. And long exhale. Inhaling. And exhaling. Feel how the body opens up. Just feel some sensation. Bend the knees, look through your hand. Walk step up, up top of your mat. Inhale halfway. Exhaling to fold. Inhale all the way up. Reach up. Exhaling, hands to heart. So let's add a few to it. Inhale, reach up. And now as you exhale, left arm comes back and right arm reaches forwards. Stay here as you inhale. So hips going forwards, turning in the torso. And as you exhale, to it a little bit more. Inhale, reach both arms up. Let's go to the other side. So right arm comes back, left arm forward, hips stay facing forwards, turning in the torso. Take a deep inhale here. And exhale. Inhale back to center, reach both arms forward. And now as you exhale, bend your knees and come into chair pose. Reach the arms as you inhale. Tailbone tucks under. And then as you exhale, let's take a twist. So the right elbow outside the left knee or the right hand. From the left hand to your waist, whichever works. Elbow, if your hands are together, go with thumbs in towards the sternum and twist. So take an inhale and then exhaling twist. Let's do one more here. Deep inhale and exhale. Push the top hand into the bottom and twist.
release, inhale back to center.
And let's exhale to the other side. So left elbow, that's not the right knee. And make sure the knees stick together. Deep inhale and exhale and twist. And inhale. Exhale and twist. Let's do one more. It's so great. Inhale. And exhale. Come back to center. Inhale into chair. Exhale, folding forwards. Inhale, lift your heart. And exhale, step back into plank. And lower halfway up. Inhale, up dog or cobra. And exhale into down dog. Inhale, right leg rises. As you exhale, right knee to right elbow, shoulders over wrists. We'll do two more like that and skip these if they don't suit you. So stay with the leg lifted or just stay in that dog. Right knee to right elbow. And last one, inhale through the guitar. And exhale, right knee to right elbow. And then from here, use this core, squeeze the knee in, and step the right foot forward between your hands. Ground the back leg, heels arch alignment. Let's come up warrior one. So reach the left arm, twist. So right waist goes back, right arm floats, and lift. And breathe here so you can look up. And now really think of it. So the baby toe side of that left foot pushes into the floor. So back leg active. Internally rotate that back leg. So really strength, pushing that back foot into the floor. And now sink into the front leg. Really nice. So now let's go carefully straighten the front leg. And shorten the stride a little bit. Straight leg, right hand on your waist, left arm lifted up. And now as you exhale, just reach the left arm forwards. And so keep thinking of left hip joint forwards, you're not going sideways. Just be a sense of right hip goes back, left hip comes forward as you reach. Reach. So really lengthen the spine, taking your time. And then your left hand comes down to the floor. So stay here for a moment. And again, think of baby toe side of the back foot, push into the floor, internally rotate that leg. And then keep the left hand where it is, or it may come to the baby toe side of the back foot, whichever works, and start to turn. So turn the navel, turn the ribs to the right, draw the shoulder back. And then you may keep the right hand on your waist, or right hand to the shoulder. Right arm reaches up and stay here, or you may look up. And here you may find that a bit more space for that left hand to go to the baby toe side. So coming in slowly, twisting, breathing. Deep inhale. And as you exhale, twist a little deeper. Really nice. So now release the right hand down and fold over that front leg. Relax the shoulders. Deep breaths. Really nice. So now lengthen the stride now. So step that back to the back. Bend the front knee. We're coming into warrior two and it will revolve pressure. So left arm forward and then the right arm reaches back. And let's do it moving with the breath. So inhale, reach both arms up. And then as you exhale, right arm back, left arm forward, and breathe. Let's do three more. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, right arm back, left arm forward, and twist. Two more. And that sense of absolutely no rush, moving with your breath, and fire up that back leg, so strong. Last one. And the wall. So now right hand comes to the back of either the left thigh or your lower back. We take a revolved so reach the left arm back. Keep that bend in the front knee. Right hip draws back and reach. And see if you can bring that right arm, right hand down a little bit more down the outside of the left leg. So really revolving. And then reach with that left arm. Really nice bend for the knee. And really carefully, let's go through Vinyasa. So hands down and step back. Take an inhale here. And exhale slowly, make your way to the floor or halfway. Inhaling up, down, cobra. And exhaling back into down dog. Take a deep inhale here. And long exhale. Inhale, left leg lengthens. And then left knee to left elbow, shoulders over wrists. Sit to your leg dog, left leg rises. Inhale. And then left knee to left elbow. Last one. Inhale. And this time, bring the left knee in towards the chest. Really squeeze the knee in. And then step the left foot forward between the hands. Ground the back foot, come up to warrior one. So standing, reach the right arm forward. Really pull the right waist, right hip, right ribs forward. And then left arm floats both arms up. Once again, activate that back leg. Internally rotate, push into the big toe side. Sink into the front leg, either look up or to the horizon, whichever is your fancy. And breathe. Notice all of the inhale and all of the exhale. Really nice. Hands to your waist. It was just like shorten your stride and straighten your front leg. Left hand stays on your waist, right arm reaches up. And now we're really slowly coming down. I want you to think of right arm reaches forward, right side comes forward. So right hip, left hip draws back, coming down. So now the right hand's on the floor and gets strong here. Draw the left hip back. Strong in that back leg, and then let's start turning towards so ribs, navel, all turning towards the left. Nice. And then maybe there's the possibility of the right hand on the big toe side of the left foot, or leaving on the big toe side. It might also be on your leg, which is perfect. And now start turning. Left hand stays on your waist. You might put your left hand on your shoulder. And then reach it up. Look up or look down. And it's one of those poses, revolve triangle. As you breathe into it, you get a little bit more of that. So suddenly maybe it's possible to move the hand, maybe it's a bit more room to reach the arm, and then maybe the balance gets steady and you can look up. And deep breaths, very strong pose. Breathing. Last breath here. Really nice, bring both hands down and fold over the straight leg. And breathe. Really nice, now legs in the stride again. Let's come up into warrior two, revolve, fashion. So left leg is forward,
So reach up with both arms. And as you exhale, right arm comes forward
and the left arm comes back. That's it, and sink low. Just do four more, inhale, reach up.
Exhaling when you reach. Really feel the twist in the ribs, navel, side ribs. Inhale, reach up. And navel twists as you exhale. Push into that back leg really strong. Two more. And exhale. And last one. And exhale. So reverse warrior, that's the word I was looking for. So a revolved reverse warrior. So reverse warrior, usually like this, we're doing the revolve, which is the left hand to out of the back of your waist, down onto your thigh, the outside of the thigh. So, and then right arm reaches up. And breathe. And you can feel it, right? You can feel that twisting. Keep drawing that left hand around, seeking to come towards the right hip. So it's really drawing the left side back and then lengthening. And breathe. Inhaling here, and then exhale very carefully, release, hands down and step back. Take a full inhale, and exhale low. Inhaling up dog or cobra, and exhale back into down dog. Inhaling. And exhaling. And here, bend your knees and come into a seated pose. So legs are forward. Bring the right foot and bring it to the outside of the left toe, left knee. Right hand is behind you. And then reach with that left arm, create all its length. And then as you exhale, left elbow comes on the outside of that right knee and turn. Bring that right hand in close to your back. And so feel, close your eyes if you're comfortable, and feel the legs up from the base of the spine all the way up, spiraling to the crown of the head. Inhale, filling up front body. As you exhale, feel the breath leave the body, draw the front body in towards the center and twist a little deeper. And now as you inhale, feel the back body fill as well. Shoulders, kidney area. As you exhale, breath leaves your body, back body draws towards the center, and you twist, turning, and foot on, that's it. And now inhale, front and back and sides fill up. As you exhale, everything draws to the center, and you revolve. One more like that, inhale, fill up. And then exhale, drawing towards the center and revolve. And now very slowly coming out of the twist. Feel the adjustment. And let's go straight to the side. So left foot now on the outside of the right knee. Left hand behind you. And then inhale, reach your crib up length. And then as you exhale, right elbow outside the left knee. Inhale, fill up chest, belly, ribs. And as you exhale, feel your front body draw towards the center and revolve. Inhale, back body fills, expands. And as you exhale, draw the back body towards the center and twist. And that deep, long inhale, fill front and back. And as you exhale, revolve. And another one, just like that, inhale. And exhale. Be nice, coming back to center. Extend both your legs. And then inhale, pull the fleshy parts back. So you're sitting on the sit bones, inhale, reach up. And then exhale, reaching forward. So hands come wherever it sits. Inhale, lift your heart. And exhale, folding. It's nice to keep the chin a little bit lifted. Chest going forward, breathing length. Deep breaths. Nice, carefully release. And let's just lie down for a moment before we come into our meditation, just to give the body a second. So lie down. Completely relax. Feel the eyes sink back towards the back of your head. Shoulders relax. Completely let go. As much as you can let go. Begin to deepen your breath. Inhale, reach your arms up and over your head. And then as you exhale, draw your knees into your chest and grab your knees and give yourself squeeze. Lots of times your hands and soles your feet together. And roll onto the right side. And then carefully coming over to the seat. So we'll do a really beautiful breath technique here. And I'm going to be guiding your attention down the front of your body and then up the back of your body with the breath. Okay, so start by come in a comfortable seat and close your eyes. And begin to notice the breath coming in and out through your nostrils, like two little streams of light going right up into the center of your brain. We stay very present, very focused on observing and feeling your breath. And if the mind wanders, notice the wandering and coming back. So get very still, very steady in your breath.
And now bring your attention into the crown of your head, very top of your head. And feel as though there's an opening there with energy coming in through the crown of your head. So I'm going to guide us in a systematic way as we exhale. I'm going to guide the breath down from the crown of the head to the third eye, the throat, heart, the navel, the pubic bone, and the base of the spine, going down the front body. And as we inhale, I'll guide us back up along the back of our body, the sacral area, the back of the navel, the back of the heart, back of the throat, back of the head, and back to the crown of the head. And please, if I'm going too slow for your breath, just go at your own pace and follow your attention, exhaling down the front of your body, and inhaling up the back of your body. And so let's start by taking a deep inhale to the crown of your head. Your attention is there. And as you exhale, feel the flow of energy, your attention coming to the third eye, to your throat, to the center of your heart, to your navel, to the pubic bone, to the base of your spine. As you inhale, your attention draws up your back body from the base of your spine to the sacral area, back of the navel, back of the heart, back of the throat, back of the head, all the way to the crown. And as you exhale, back down the front body, third eye, throat, heart center, navel, pubic bone, base of the spine, inhaling, base of the body, sacral area, back of the navel, back of the heart, back of the throat, back of your head, to the crown of your head. And then exhale down the front of your body. Again, third eye, throat, heart center, navel, pubic bone, base of the spine. Inhaling up the back body, sacral area, back of the navel, back of the heart, back of the throat, back of the head, crown of the head. And continue a few more rounds and see, can you make the exhale a little longer? So controlling a long exhale and let the inhale just be at a comfortable pace, whatever works for you. Internalizing the mind, directing your attention into these internal pathways. So now I want you to move your attention with similar breath, but instead of being at the front and back of the body, you're going to stay in the inside, in the center. So as you exhale, you're coming down through the center of the body, third eye, throat, heart, navel, pubic bone, base of the spine. And as you inhale, you come back up through the center of your body. Pubic bone, navel, heart, throat, third eye, crown of the head. And so a few rounds like this, exhaling down through the center of your body. Inhaling up through the center of your body. And become curious about this inner pathway. So we're going to do
alternate nostril sequence. And so we do three rounds in each direction. So using your right hand, block your left nostril and inhale through your right nostril. Long, deep breath. And then exhale left. So block the right nostril and exhale to your left. Do three more just like that. Inhale right. Exhaling left. Inhale right. Exhale left. One more. Inhale right. And exhale left. Release your hand down, take a deep inhale through both nostrils. And then gently exhale. Take a few breaths now through both nostrils and stay super present. Super connected, so tuning in. That real subtlety of you. Now go to the other side. So we're going to inhale through the left this time. So block your right nostril. And exhale right. Inhale left. Exhaling right. Inhale left. Exhaling right. Last one, inhale left, and exhaling right, release your hand down, and just take a few breaths here. Feeling the energy through your chest. Arms. Really be present. And notice how you're witnessing, observing mind sharpens as the distractions diminish. So we're going to take, it's almost like a breath of fire, so 12 sharp in and out through the left nostril. So block your right nostril, and it's a stronger, like, okay, and do 12, so off you go. Take a deep inhale. Hold the breath. Exhale, release. take a moment here. And now go to the other side. So block the left nostril and 12 breaths, sharp breaths in and out to the right nostril. Take a deep inhale. Pause, hold. Stay here for a moment, just breathing. Notice the effect of the sharp breaths in the right nostril. Harmonization between the left and right hemisphere. Balance. And then sun, main female. And so stay here just for these last few minutes, fully present. And if you're looking for more emotional stability, bring your attention to your heart center. And for you, you prefer to focus on mental stability, bring your attention to the throat. So your attention is either resting at your heart, at your third eye, and you visualize light energy. Where your attention is resting. Tuning in to the subtlety of you. Tuning into the wonderland of your own consciousness. Becoming familiar with the inner workings of itself. Even I am not thinking. Into me, I see. Stay super present, just a few more moments. Every thought has a ripple. Every word a stronger ripple.
and every action even stronger than that. And when we practice meditation, we start to reel it back in. We start to correct at the level of thought, refine our words, and become really skillful in our actions. So cultivating that witness, observing mind, really strengthens our ability to self-correct. So now begin to deepen the breath again. Bring your hands to prayer, to heart center. And bow to that wise being within you. And may you stay connected to your subtlety as you go through your day. May you hone your skills of self-correction. And may you be kind to yourself. And I would encourage you, if you have the opportunity over the next few days, to just do this breathing practice first thing in the morning. It sets a really beautiful tone. It sets your mind before you face into the world. I think it's about 16 or 18 minutes or so. And try it and see if it works for you. Thank you so much. Catch the last few names. Mm-hmm.